Okay, the next barrier algorithm we're going to look at is what is called a tournament barrier. The barrier is organized in the form of a tournament with n players, and since it's a tournament with n players and two players playing against each other in every match, there are going to be log n rounds, log n to the base 2. So here is a setup for, with n equal to 8, there are going to be three rounds corresponding to log n, n being 8. We get three rounds, the first round, second round, and the third round. So in the first round, there are going to be four matches. P0 and P1 is one match, P2, P3, P4, P5, and P6, P7. And the only catch is that we're going to rig this tournament. In other words, what's going to happen is that we're going to predetermine who is going to be the winner in this round. And particularly, we're going to say P0 is the winner for this match, P2 for this one, P4 for this one, and P6 for this one. So in other words, the matches are rigged in this day and age when we hear about international scandals about match fixing. I guess this is not too far-fetched. But what is the rationale for match fixing? The key rationale is the fact that if these processors are executing on a shared memory machine, then the winner can basically sit on his bumper and wait for processor P1 to come over and let him know that that he has won the match. P2 can wait till P3 comes over, and so on and so forth. And what that means in a shared memory multiprocessor is that the spin location where P0 is waiting for P1 to come and inform him that he's lost the match is fixed, is static. So this is the idea behind match fixing, that the spin location for each of these processes, P0, P2, and P4, and P6, the winners in the first round, is predetermined. And that is very, very useful, especially if you don't have a cache-coherent multiprocessor. If you have NCC NUMA machine, in that case, it is possible to locate the spin location in the memory that is very close to P0, P2, P4, and P6, respectively. That's the idea behind this match fixing. So as a result of the first round of matches, of course, P0 will advance to the next round, P2 will advance to the next round, P4 and P6. And once again, in the second round, we're going to fix the matches, and the winner is going to be P0 for round 2, P4 for on this bracket for round 2. And so essentially what that means again is that P0 and P4 can spin on a statically determined location in their processors, and P2 and P6 respectively will come over and let the other guy know that won the match at least for this round. So that is the end of the second round. And of course, if you have, with n equal to 8, there are only three rounds. But if for arbitrary n, we're going to have more levels in the tree, and in every level, we're going to fix the winners. And so it'll propagate up this tree in this fashion in terms of determining statically who are going to be the winners for each round of the tournament. And this will go on all the way up to determining who the tournament champion is. So in this case, P0 is our lucky guy who wins the tournament, and so he's a champion. And so P0 is going to be waiting on a statically determined location where P4 can come and signal that P0 has won the tournament. So again, the important thing that I want you to get out of this this particular arrangement that I mentioned is the fact that the spin location for each of the processes that is waiting on the other guy is statically determined at every level. So this is the first round, the second round, and finally the championship round.